Vamos por detalles.
They're doing a very good job in Intramuros.
Absolutely, yes.
So far. Good secretary of Romulo, the Intramuros administrators, Tony Asido, and other historic agencies, really.
It's a huge attraction for your city, I mean, to have that historic center.
And that's one of our, asset. As a city, comparatively with our neighboring cities, who are more developed than us, but we have much character.
Yeah, exactly.
Story to tell.
Exactly. It's a huge asset, and which can be used for developing tourism. And I know that it's very much one of the priorities that
we're trying to
looking for.
See whatever is left. Resumption of peace talk again in the Netherlands.
That's what we hear as well. So that is good news. We hope that they stopped like 2 years ago. So they took it up again.
Hopefully.
Yeah.
There are some hiccups.
Yeah.
I think Colombia was very successful in some aspect with regard to the anti-corruption in their respective country. Their country. These are the things that may be worth emulating or duplicating. Hopefully. At the end of the day, we are all Filipinos.
Well, that's indeed the situation. The first part is, of course, a negotiation and an agreement, and the second part is always the most difficult one, to make the peace work.
Yes.
And to have all parties supporting it. So, So what is your analysis for the possible success of those negotiations?
Well, we're always hopeful. The most expensive thing in this world with regard to governance is peace.
Mm-hmm.
It's expensive in such a way, if you put it in right perspective.
Mm-hmm.
It's hard to achieve, but it's achievable.
Mm-hmm.
It's doable. And everybody should anchor that hope that it can be done. Because a lot of countries did that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Even in the worst situation, they reached a certain level of peace compared to what they used to.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I just talked to the ambassador from Germany. She went back here a few minutes ago. And can you imagine that the German people will be united after X number of decades? See, it's achievable. It's
a
matter of time, consistency, and persistence. Be stumbling blocks along the way, but if we continue to pursue the journey, one way or another, we'll arrive there. It's just a question of time.
I hope that you will get positive vibes back from the Netherlands, from the NDF group who is negotiating.
Hopefully.
Yeah.
We are always hopeful.
Yeah.
I wish a lot of Filipino will know that in Netherlands, if I'm not mistaken, you only have about 3% of crime rate. That involves only lost bicycle. Because of
true.
The interchanging bicycle. I was laughing. There's 180,000 registered complaint. What's that? They're looking for their bicycle.
Well, it's an issue. The safety of the bike is an issue. But there are also other safety issues where we have to look into.
I'm happy for you. You are one of the most productive country, peaceful, progressive, straightforward, open-minded leaders of your country.
And we welcome many of your fellow citizens in the Netherlands, many seafarers who are traveling through the Netherlands. You know that they are the preferred nationality.
We are very good seamen.
You are excellent seamen. So the seafarers are in fact manning our ships, and also the ships of other nationalities. And it means that we see many of the seafarers transiting through Rotterdam. Rotterdam is the biggest port in Europe. So many ships come and with a cargo.
We're very good seamen, I think, because of our natural geography.
Absolutely.
We are an archipelagic.
And you are investing in their training. So making them.
The state is really into it.
Yeah.
And we have a lot of good schools.
Yeah.
Maritime school
mm-hmm.
in the country.
Mm-hmm.
very good mining agency also, quality upgraded.
So that
techniques.
Is something that indeed binds us, this joint interest in the maritime sector and in sailing the seven oceans.
I hope that someday somehow the state will copy what you did with your open space farming.
Mm-hmm.
You still believe in agriculture? Yes, that's what I'm always saying. If they only see it, I always, when I go abroad for work, I go around, try to look around for this country to survive with all these agriculture products. There must be something good in the agriculture.
Mm-hmm.
And we are an agricultural country also. They're building more open space, putting more water to the farms.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the dikes and the
greenhouse. Yeah, we're looking into possibilities to share technological knowledge about how to develop agriculture. We have invested a lot in the Netherlands in research and agricultural research, and the strengths agriculture is the linkage between research and producers. So what research is coming up with is shared directly with the producers, and they will start to apply it, and they will also give feedback to the researchers. And so it has created a very strong linkage, and it's one of the success factors.
And you're a very good designer, just so you know. I like Netherlands design, buildings, furnitures.
Mm-hmm. You know,
you
do.
Yes. We have very talented designers, architectural, other things. I like there is more in less concept.
Absolutely.
I hope I might. Visit again soon.
Nice.
The Netherlands. Yeah, I just talked to the British ambassador. I'm going to do some trainings in London again. Then I might visit, pass by Paris, and go to Amsterdam to show to some of our colleagues here.
Yeah.
I want to show them. So I might have a few hours.
We'll be happy to assist you for program to some items that may be of interest for you. I know that you have been very much into looking into the interest of the cleaning up of Manila Bay. Manila Bay is a sector where we've been working together with NEDA for the development of the master plan, Manila Bay master plan. We're seeing that with Manila Bay being completely fully built, you don't need a master plan. But the master plan is about, for example, about waste management. It's about water management. It's about groundwater management. It's about the informal settlements. It's about the environment in the bay and the fisheries, and about land reclamation criteria and so on. And so this is a huge project with NEDA, and the master plan will be ready by mid this year. And but that's only the start, you know, because a plan is a plan.
Will find a leader who follows plan.
The next step will be the implementation, and that's where all partners will be required to play their role. Maybe this is something that we could offer you, to organize a special presentation for you and your team on this Manila Bay Master Plan, and with NEDA, and that you get briefed on what the ideas are. The important thing is that in this Manila Bay Master Plan, we also want to involve their needs are taken into account in the master plan.
We want to learn from your urban plan.
Yeah. So, but we have learned that you cannot do without working with the people who are living there. Huh? So you have to involve them and to inform them and to make sure they are involved in developing the plan, in thinking out the plan, so that they will also support the implementation to that phase. So I think it would be of great interest for all parties if we could brief you.
We'll be happy to
miss
and learn.
So, yes, so with your team. And so, well, I think that issues like the waste management are huge issues, and I know that for Secretary Simatu of the
he's very active.
He's very active, and
and
he said waste management is the one single most important issue that I want to solve before the end of my tenure. And it's an area where you need everybody to be involved, the local government units, the municipalities, the private sector.
We guarantee the secretary that no more mayor will throw garbage in the water just to pick it up.
Indeed.
In our own little way.
Well, that's a start, but a very important one.
They're doing a very good job. We're very grateful to President Duterte making it as a matter of priority. That about 2 kilometer length of the famous Manila Bay, or Manila portion, because as geographically speaking, you know, Manila Bay is composed of so many LGUs. In the south, we have Batangas, Cavite, Las Piñas, Parañaque, Pasay, then Manila.
Yeah.
In the north, we have Bataan, Pampanga, Bulacan, Malabon, Nabotas, then Manila.
Yeah.
But when you try to Google map this, you know, this is Corregidor, you know, so this is like Manila Bay. So hopefully our neighboring LGUs will do their waste management also with regard to waste, water waste, you know, because during regular day, the water will come in and towards the land and bring all those garbage
exactly.
All the way to
ironically
it's Manila because we have a we have a catchment technically speaking. So what we do in our own little way, since I assume office, what is CSI? While DPWH, MMDA, and DNR is now building a very good facility, a required facility with regard to waste water coming out from inland. They're going to put a machine or a system by Ross Boulevard. And I think it's going to be finished within the year. That's because of the direction of the president and the decision also of the Supreme Court, the mandamus issue. So what we do as local government, in our own little while they're doing their thing, is we created a task force that every day this group of individuals by the city government keeps on picking up all those garbage in the area. But it's every day. We are very persistent, if I may put that in right perspective, in terms of physically picking up those garbage coming from our neighboring communities. But I think if everybody, the people all over surrounding Manila Bay, cooperate, doing self-discipline, will be more successful because the state is not doing their part. And we should do our part, local government and as people, citizens.
Mm-hmm. Hopefully we'll learn a lot of things. Mm-hmm. And we guarantee you that we are now addressing our air quality mm-hmm. in the city by duplicating sound in your area, concept which we, what we call vertical garden, mm-hmm. Making more open green space, opening more parks that used to be a park, bringing it to life, making it more available to the general public, and putting more greeneries in the area. So to address our air quality, and we are also addressing our creeks in the city. If you check the map of the city, Manila is being divided by creeks. Mm-hmm. These are feeder water to Pasig River to Manila Bay. So we wanted to go all the way to the source of fill or waste. It's a long process. Like, Rome was not built in one day. It's a long process, yeah.
But it can be done.
That's one thing that we assure our people in Manila. We will be consistent. And I've been calling the attention of everybody to participate, not throwing garbage in the river. Mm-hmm. But having said that, we continue to clean.
Yeah.
The key is the people. And I think that that's the most important thing. There is already laws, rules, policies, programs. And the only missing link is the people.
And they need an alternative for not throwing it in the river or the creek.
We just provided bins. In the inner room,
yeah.
Where trucks or garbage collectors can go in, we provided the bins, mm-hmm. garbage bins. About a few weeks ago, mm-hmm. we identified where the garbage is mass.
Yeah,
it's a long, mm-hmm. Long creek. So we try to identify what community. Particular community portion of barangay where continue doing unnecessary things.
Yeah. Well, I'd like to mention also the initiatives by some Dutch companies. The group Unilever, they produce all kinds of products for consumers like toothpaste and soap and etc. And it all comes in packaging. And their initiative now is to collect back the packaging that goes into a community. So that's what they are doing in Tondo.
We're doing that already, Your Excellency. Two companies we partnered with, Unilever.
Yeah. Alaska is another.
Alaska, we just signed a memorandum with them. Yeah. Another one is Unilever and Cemex. No? Yeah. Cemex, yeah. They're buying back packaging.
Yeah.
With good products.
It's positive that the private sector is supporting this kind of initiatives and is coming up with its own efforts.
Yeah.
So we support it very much. I'd like to see how we can work further on that issue of packaging and what to do with them, or reduce packaging, because that's also something to be looked into. So, sustainability is the label under which we work here in the Philippines with our embassy. So sustainability, innovation, the protection of the environment, and also new technologies, circular economies. That is the whole. That is the kind of work, kind of sectors
note,
that we like to work.
On the other note. Your Excellency, let me take this opportunity to invite you and those who are interested. You know, this concept of ours came from an event in Amsterdam, and I was there, the EU Pride. You hosted it a few years ago. I was there in Del Plaza.
Oh,
yes, I was there. Doon ako particular nag-check-in to witness the EU Pride.
Mm-hmm.
And I saw it. I saw...
Sorry.
So I have a back pain. But I saw it where, you know, government, European government is really into, you know, this type of events and occasion. And I'm very happy that, you know, with some members of the EU who has a history of not respecting others' right or preference in life, and now they're joining together and seeing this event, the EU Pride.
Mm-hmm.
And because of that, so when I became mayor last July, I tasked tourism to come up and make a state the city, not only through our statement, but through our action. And I tasked Director Charlie Dumo to come up with Pride Parade in the city to show them who we are as city government. Chauvinism doesn't exist anymore in this city government. Everybody here is being looked at equal. We are certain about it. So to show the substance to our words is we will conduct our Pride Parade this coming April. It's a summer thing. And it's for free. Free. I just want to create an atmosphere of expressions of oneself. Because that's very important to me. That anybody can express themselves respectfully. Because love begets love. And we want them to feel that they belong. That's why on April we will have a free Pride Parade.
Will it be the first one here in Manila?
In Manila, yes.
Okay.
In Manila. It's going to be the first.
Yeah.
Because we have a lot of communities also who are engaged in their respective events. I've seen it, I've experienced it. And I just want to make it real.
Count me in.
Oh, okay, that's nice. Oh, Charlie, huh? So, Vienna, EU minister, the one.
We have 15 countries.
Oh, now Netherlands.
And I'm sure
that
my team will also be there.
I want to show it to the world.
Yeah.
I want to show it to the world, to the country, that we respect each individual's preference in life.
Well, that's very much
discrimination.
With our views. And
we want to show them humanity in the city. With all honesty. And it's free. No fees. They just all come here. We will be happy to host them. This is a start. I saw it. I swear to God, it's about what I saw in Amsterdam.
EU
Pride.
Yes.
I saw it. I was there. I was like, they're doing this. There must be ample reason and specific reason for the government to recognize,
to promote it. Well, it has become a very spectacular show of identity also of the LGBT community. So it's very, very colorful, as you have noticed. And the nice thing is that they take advantage of the canals in Amsterdam, so they pass by on the barges, and so the audience is on the side on the land, and they watch
people watching
this parade going by, sailing by. So it's beautiful.
Hopefully, we can copy what you have done in that hosting of the EU Pride.
So if you need some ideas or some,
yes,
we have to do that.
Makasuyo, baka tumawag sa iyo si Charlie.
No.
Gusto ko yun.
Yes, teacher, no problem.
Para inclusiveness.
Yes.
Mm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You're actually following your policies, sir, and all the statements that you've been making really to support non-discrimination.
Yes, I don't like it.
Yes.
I don't like chauvinism. Mm-hmm. I really don't like
yes.
it. I don't like it.
That's why when we got the invitation to join the summer pride, we really are very interested, and that's why we asked for something as well. We're very excited.
Hopefully, we'll bring colors and vibrancy in the city.
Indeed.
That's awesome. That's you know, if you look at our history, we're so diverse. The city of Manila, comparatively speaking, with our neighboring cities, you know, we have Intramuros, we have Paris of the East, the biggest Chinatown in the world in terms of population. So, two different worlds, you know, it's here, divided by a river, a river known Pasig River, where Manila, where we got our name, flowers in the Pasig, Nila, that's what they say, Maynila, Maynila. So it's very, there's always a story to tell about Manila. And I think that generates some traction, it will generate some traction, economically speaking, economically speaking, for individuals and business life. So we're happy
forward,
to see
yeah.
you.
Yes, absolutely.
Oh, maganda ito.
Yeah.
Manila. We are the capital. We wanted to start it here.
Yeah.
So. And it's duplicable.
It
I
is.
Told you it's.
Yeah.
I'm just copying it
everywhere.
From your.
And there has been one in Mindanao.
Yes.
The
Orchard. Wow,
so
that's
yeah,
nice.
Yeah.
That's
2018.
Nice.
The first Pride March in Mindanao, we partnered with several organizations to support it.
And we wanted every organization to join. All over the country and internationally to visit Manila.
You're bringing Europe to Manila.
Hopefully,
you
know.
By the European ambassador.
We were once called the Paris of the East. Yes, that's how they describe our forefathers described Manila as the Paris of the East, the Pearl of the Orient. So we'll try to revive that kind of expectations.
Absolutely.
From us.
Yeah. So it's Paris has always been a city of enlightenment.
Yeah.
So.
City of lights.
And
history.
So Manila can be that as well.
Sure.
Yeah.
Fashion.
Yeah. But they have better designers.
I
saw it.
We were talking about
architecture.
We were talking about Manila. You were mentioning Manila and its very rich history. And so we'd like to share with you two books about the history of Manila, and also about the relations between Manila and the Philippines and the Netherlands during the over the centuries. So it starts in colonial times. Maybe that wasn't such a fortunate encounter at the time. But it is a rich relation.
If I'm not mistaken, that there was an attempt by the Dutch to come in the country, due to unfortunate weather in Pangasinan, it halted. It was written by our famous national artist in literature, if I'm not mistaken, Mr. Nick Joaquin, that the Dutch tried to go to country with the fleet, X number of fleet, while the two fleet of the Spanish colonials is located, stationed here in Manila. But due to our weather, tropical condition, it could have been taller, like the Netherlands.
If I may, Mayor, those two particular books are interesting with your drive to bring back the glory of Manila, because the visitors, especially in that second book, with three Dutch visitors, they came here during the American colonial era, and one of them,
Dr. Aletta Jacobs was the very first woman to graduate with a medical degree
mm-hmm.
from the Netherlands, and she was a suffragist. And when she came to Manila, she met with the pioneer suffragists in the Philippines.
Wow.
So there was a lot of exchanges between the Dutch and the Philippines even then.
Malaking bagay ito. So that, kasi ang naalala lang na people are always reminded of the Spanish, or the Americans,
mm-hmm.
the Japanese, but you know, we have also the Malays,
mm-hmm.
Borneans,
mm-hmm.
you know, Dutch, all other things. And in fact, I think most of the Jewish community is grateful to Manila during the time of during troubled times.
Yeah, when they were offered refuge.
We were the first country who welcomed.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
More than a thousand.
Yes,
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. That is a very important role to play in history.
We come to think of it.
Yeah.
Manila has so many stories to tell.
Yes,
mm-hmm.
Yeah, a lot of stories. Yeah.
She said it was like being put under the internet, it has to be revived.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm very grateful with the national government, Secretary Berna Romulo and
mm-hmm.
his team and her team,
mm-hmm.
you know, reviving whatever is left there,
yeah.
try to support.
Mm-hmm.
Well, now we're going to hopefully it will be finished by May and we start showing our one of our famous theater. Metropolitan Theater. Yes. It's being restored. There's an ongoing restoration. We're very happy. We used to own this through the years.
Mm-hmm.
of some leaders of the city. But trying to get back to
sleep. If we can support you in whatever way, continue this this exchange with you and with your team on a number of subjects of the Manila Bay master plan, the biking, can work on that issue, and if we can support your initiative on the Pride Parade,
mm-hmm.
that's we're happy to do so.
Please,
and,
please.
And would you have a point of contact within your administration.
Charlie is the head of.
Could exchange on organizing a presentation for on the master plan.
Please, Charlie saka si architect Dennis Lacuna. He's he's an architect by profession, but now he's also an urban planner. Class, the examination a few months ago. Kasi gusto ko yung urban design ng Netherlands. Can you imagine a street, just one street, rail, cars, bicycle, and foot traffic, all in one street. Pag inisyon, walang accident. There's no accident happening. So it can...
So it's infrastructure, it's also training of people. And it's designing smart plans for cycling.
Oh, we can also purchase some books from
okay.
About biking.
Okay.
The Dutch are known for their water expertise.
Yes.
Water management.
Saka yun, farm, agriculture.
Yes, also. Yes.
So this is another photo book because you mentioned that you really love the Netherlands. So,
sabi ko sa inyo, hindi ko kayo binubola. I know what I'm talking about. I always observe, Your Excellency. I always observe. I always observe. Well, because sometimes you don't have to reinvent the wheel.
Exactly.
There is...
Smart copying.
Yes. I always copy. One at a time.
Yeah.
What is... what are the things that can blend with our customs? And traditions
just to fit
with new technology,
mm-hmm.
new ways,
mm-hmm.
science, engineering, knowledge. Hopefully.
Okay.
Hopefully. Oh, Your Excellency, well, I would like to let me give this to you. Okay. This is the simple token for the city government.
Mm-hmm. This is not a simple problem.
This is the key.
Beautiful work.
The key to the city. It speaks of that any time that you wish to come to the city of Manila, you can open the city up.
That is really very, very intentional. Very honored. Thank you very much. That is really.
And so this is for your. I don't know if you can use this daily, but it can be used daily. This is a placemat. But it depicts the old Manila.
Yes.
Yung mga old pictures of Manila, the way it was.
Nice.
Very
nice. Yeah. Really like it.
Yeah. It's an honest copy.
And I can see that you found our flag.
Almost similar. Almost similar.
And so, as a token of our appreciation.
I saw this in hand.
I
always go there.
Souvenir from our visit here. So, and as a token of our appreciation and hope that this is the start of a very positive collaboration. And we are open to next steps. And hope to welcome you on your next trip to the Netherlands. If we can support you to organize a good program that you can visit those items that pique your interest.
Traffic is very good. It's well planned in Netherlands.
So that is something that you might be interested in.
Yes, traffic and wastewater.
Wastewater.
Tricks.
Okay. Good. Yes.
You have PhD in making canals.
Not only canals, I mean dikes and several other things on water.
And when are you traveling?
Oh, I might leave on the 7th, 3 days in London.
Next month?
Next month.
Already?
Next
sure,
month.
Maybe we can go.
Next time I can go there in particular, on a particular subject.
Okay,
good.
Well,
Thank you
very much.
Thank you for the books.
Yes.
And the guests.
Talaga pwede
yun, applicable yung ginagawa nila.
They actually have a very good school on urban planning. There's the last one.
Baka pwede kaming magdala ng
special
program.
Yes. We have organized a program before for the vice governors. Big.
Kami yung mga arkitekto namin sa Iliniero. Kasi gusto ko buhayin yung tranvía. And the best example of it is Netherlands.
Okay.
The tram. It's easy
to
build it. Talaga, you don't have to build vertically.
Yes.
You just slice the street,
right.
Put
the lines,
that's it. In a few months, you have 100 meters, 200 meters, 300 meters, 1 kilometer, 2 kilometers. And it's scalable.
Yes.
You just build the backbone, and you do the fishbone.
Yes. We're bringing here some urban planning experts from the Netherlands, both specialists in cycling, but also in broader urban planning, together with a Philippine real estate company. And we hope that the symposium inviting local government executives also.
Yes, we'll be happy to be there. And I'll bring some key personality in our respective department.
Very good to hear.
I want them to see what I saw. So that when we talk, we're in sync.
Yes. Sometimes bring people into the same page is one of the most critical steps.
I saw something. So when I talk to them, this is vertical garden. Sir, how? Oh, you put water line here, there. This can be sustainable. And we did it with the bridge.
Yes.
In our streets. In our streets. Anyway. Go there.
He can prepare a very specific
for you.
Even for just.
If you can have your own flow,
Yeah.
Yeah, ang ganda ng mga nila, agriculture.
Says blood controlling.
No, blood control.
Blood control.
And Mayor, at the risk of presenting so many tokens, we also wanted to lend this maybe for your sport activities. It's, it's an orange colored football. You can't mistake it for anything.
Thank you. I won't mistake it. I won't miss it. Don't worry.
So,
we
have a
group
photo.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, group photo. Here, with the ambassador.
Okay.
Sinalubong naman sila ng banda.
Of course,
good. Meron ba silang play na Netherlands song?
No, that is
you mean? Oh, very good.
They did it, and they played it very well, though.
Okay, who is your
answer?
Sorry. I am a small office.
I don't want to say things to
me. Pwede pa sentro sa basketball.
Yes, very much so. Center.
Kaya nga kung nalayan tayo ng Netherlands, at tatakad siguro natin.
Basketball is not okay, one
favorite
sport.
Okay.
Another one.
Wait.
Manila
God. Oh, God first. Oh, there you go. This is our sign in Manila.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. I'll send you. Yung jambin.